Hello friends, welcome to my YouTube channel. Today we are going to discuss linear programming method for finding value of game and optimal strategy for player A as well as for player B. Friends, I had already discussed this method in Hindi. If you want to watch in Hindi, I had provided link in the description. You can watch from there. And I suggest you please watch this video step by step till end. I am assured you will understand. And if you have any doubt regarding this method, you can ask me. I have provided my WhatsApp number in the description. So let us start. We are given with the 3x3 matrix. Here player A uses 3 strategies and player B uses 3 strategies. Now step number 1. Find out the saddle point, if any, in the payoff matrix. Okay, here we start with the first row. The minimum element in the first row is -1, so I had written row minimum here -1, and the minimum element in the second row is -3 here, and the minimum element in the third row is -2. I had written here. Then we have to find out the maximum element among these 3 element. Here the maximum one is -1. Okay, so I encircle this with a triangle. Okay, now we have to find out the greatest element, that is column maximum, which is in the first column is 6, in second column is 5, and in the third column is 3. Okay, now we have to find out the minimum among these maximum values. Here the minimum value is 3, so I encircled this 3, which is minimax. Okay, from above table, value of game lies between -1 and 3. We know that value of game always lies between max min and minimax point, that is -1 and 3. So I had written here -1 less than or equal to V less than or equal to 3. This is our first step. Now we proceed to step number 2. It is possible that the value of game may be negative or 0, because the value of game lies between -1 to 3. So it is possible that value of game may be negative or 0. So we add a constant k is equal to 4. Here the maximum negative value is -3. So if we add 4 to these element of the payoff matrix, then all the elements will be positive. So I have decided to add constant k, that is 4, to all the elements of the matrix to make them positive. Okay, assuming the value of game represented by this new matrix is non-negative and non-zero. Okay, now when I add 4 plus 1, I will get 5. Then -3 plus 1, I will get 3. Then 3 plus 4, 7. Okay, 3 plus 4, 7. 4 plus 9. -3 plus 4, 1. 6 plus 4, 10. 4 plus 2, 6. -4 plus 4, that is 2. Now, let x1, x2, x3 and y1, y2, y3 be the probabilities for A selecting his strategies a1, a2, a3, and y1, y2 be the probabilities for player B selecting his strategies b1, b2, b3. Okay. Now we proceed to the step number 3. B's problem is, now we have to find out the problem of B. Here the problem of B is find the value of y1, y2, y3. Okay, which minimize V dash, that is which minimize the loss for B, where V dash represent loss for player B. We have assumed that player A gains and player B makes loss. So player B will always try to minimize his loss. Now the expected payoff, or we can say that expected loss to player B when player A uses his first strategy, that is A1. The expected loss to player B will be 5 multiplied by probability of B1, that is Y1. 5 Y1, so I had written here 5 Y1 plus probability of B2 is Y2, so 3 multiplied by Y2 plus 7 multiplied by Y3. Okay, less than or equal to V dash. Why less than? Because player B always try to minimize his loss. Okay. In the same way, when player B uses A2 strategy, the expected payoff to player B will be 3 multiplied by y1 plus 9 multiplied by y2 plus 1 multiplied by y3. So I had written here 7y1 plus 9y2 plus y3 less than or equal to v dash. In the same way, when player A uses third strategy, expected payoff to player B will be 10y1, 6y2 plus 2y3. So I had written here. And the sum of these probabilities is equal to 1. Okay. And y1, y2, y3 is greater than or equal to 0. As we know that probabilities are always 0 or greater than 0. And the maximum probability is equal to 1. Now we proceed to the step number 4. Here v dash is greater than 0, dividing the above equation by v dash. Now we divide v dash to this equation. Here I will get 5y1 upon v dash plus 3y2 upon v dash plus 7y3 upon v dash less than or equal to v dash upon v dash. In the same way, I will divide v dash to all these equations. I will get the result here. Okay. Then putting y1 upon v dash is equal to capital y1 and y2 upon v dash capital y2 and y3 upon v dash capital y3. Okay. Here maximum z, because I had taken for b, I had taken the problem of b, so the subject here will be maximum, because here v dash is minimized, because player b always try to minimize his loss, and maximum, which is the reciprocal of minimum. So I had taken this maximum z, which is equal to 1 upon v dash is equal to here y1 upon v dash is equal to capital y1, y2 upon v dash is equal to capital y2, y3 upon v dash is equal to capital y3. Okay. In the same way, I had put all these value here, and I will get the desired conditions here. Okay. Now we will proceed to the step number 5. I'm applying simplex method. Now we will apply simplex method. First of all, we will introduce slake variable. Here in the first, I had introduced y4. In the second line, I had introduced y5 and y6. Okay, greater than. Okay, friends. After that, I had constructed simplex table. Here, cj 1110, yb, that is solution values, 111, cb, coefficient of the base, that is y4, y5, y6 are the coefficient of base, y4, y5, y6, base. Okay, and y1, y2, y3, y5, here, these are the values, coefficient of y1, coefficient of y2, coefficient of y3, and coefficient of y4. Coefficient of y5 here is 0, and coefficient of y6 is 0, so I had written here 0, 0. In the same way, for second and third. Friends, I had already discussed simplex method, and if you want to watch simplex method, I had provided link in the description. You can watch from there. So here, del j, which is equal to cj minus zj, which is equal to 1110. Now here the problem is of maximization, so all del j should be either 0 or less than 0. Here there are three values which are greater than 0, so the solution is not optimal. Now we have to find the optimal solution. For that, we will choose a column which will enter into the basis and a vector which will leave from basis. For this, I have to select any of the element from del j which is greatest. Here these are all these three are equal. Now we have the option to choose any of these three values. I have chosen this one. This column will enter into the basis. Now I will have to choose the row which will leave from basis. For this, we have to find the minimum ratio, that is xb upon y3. Okay, 1/7, 1/1, 1/2. I had written here the minimum value among these is 1/7. Okay, so this row will leave from basis, that is y4 will leave and y3 will enter into the basis, y3, y5, y6. Okay, then I have to make this column an identity column, that is 7, I have to convert 7 into 1, this 0 and here 0. In order to make here 1, I will divide the whole row by 7, then I will get 1 in this place. When I will divide by 7, I will get 1/7, 5/7, so I had written here 3/7, 1 by 7, that is 1, 1 by 7, 0 and 0. And then I have to subtract 1 minus 1 in order to get 0 here. Okay, I will subtract 1 minus 1, that is 0. Then 9 minus 3 by 7, I will get 60 by 7. Then 7 minus 5 by 7, this value. And 1 minus 1 by 6, 6 by 7, I will get 5 by 7. In the same way for third row. Okay. Here del j is still greater than or equal to 0 for these two values. So here the biggest value is 4 by 7. So this column will enter into the basis. Then we have to find out the ratio. Okay. Here the minimum ratio is 1 by 10. So this row will leave from basis. Okay. And then I will find out del j. Okay. And then I will construct new table. Here del j is either 0 or less than 0. That is del j is less than or equal to 0. So this is the required optimal solution. From this table, y3 is equal to 1 by 10. y2 is equal to 1 by 10. And y1 is not available here. So y1 will equal to 0. So maximize z, which is equal to y1 plus y2 plus y3, that is 0 plus 1 by 10, 1 by 10, which is equal to 1 by 5. Okay, here maximum z is equal to 1 by v dash. So z is equal to 1 by v dash, which is equal to maximum z 1 by 5. So 1 by v dash is equal to 1 by 5. That is on taking reciprocal, v dash is equal to 5. Okay, now we have to find out the value of original y1, y2, y3, that is small y1, small y2 and small y3. Okay, here y1, we have put y1 divided by v dash is equal to capital Y. If you want to find the value of small y1, then we have to multiply v dash with capital y1. Okay, then I will get small y1 is equal to capital y1 into v dash. Okay, that is y1 is equal to small capital y1 multiplied by v dash. Capital y1 is 0, so 0 multiplied by v dash is 5. Okay, in the same way y2 is equal to capital y2 v dash, which is equal to 1 by 10 multiplied by 5, v dash is equal to 5. Okay, y3 is equal to capital y3, that is 1 by 10 multiplied by v dash, which is equal to 5. Okay, I will get 1 by 2. And the value of original game is equal to v dash, that is 5, and the element which I had already added to the payoff matrix in the first step, which was 4. So I will subtract minus 4. Okay, the original value of game is equal to 1. Okay, now we will find out the strategy for A. Here A strategy are the dual of above problem. Okay, so the value of capital X1, capital X2 and capital X3 will be the value of slack variable y4, y5, y6, that is minus 2 by 5, 1 by 5 and 0. Okay, neglecting the negative value. So I will get 2 by 15, sorry. This is minus 2 by 15. After neglecting the negative values, I will get 2 by 15, 1 by 15 and 0. 2 by 15, 1 by 15 and 0. Now, as in the above, we have to find the original value of small x1, x2 and x3. So here x1 will be capital x1 multiplied by v dash, as here. Small capital x1 is equal to 2 by 15, v dash is 5. So on simplifying, I will get 2 by 3. For x2, capital x2 into v dash, capital x2 is 1 by 15. So after simplifying, I will get 1 by 3. And small x3, which is equal to capital x3 into v dash, that is x3 is equal to 0 multiplied by 5, which is equal to 0. Hence, the optimal strategies for A will be 2 by 3, 1 by 3 and 0. And the optimal strategies for B will be 0, 1 by 2 and 1 by 2. 0, 1 by 2 and 1 by 2. And value of game, which I had subtracted from v dash, that is 1. So value of game is equal to 1. This is the required solution. Friends, if you like my video, please subscribe my channel and share this video with your friends. Thanks for watching.